Hello everyone, I'm Sushant. I welcome you to the Nimbus Learning Platform channel. This video is about 10 questions of plant biotechnology in which you learn concepts, and they are very important also for GATE examination. And so let's start this video. This is the first question. So this question is asking about what is correct about TI plasmid. So first come to TI plasmid. What is TI plasmid? Tumor inducing plasmid. This plasmid is found where? For example, Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So why does Agrobacterium tumefaciens has this TI plasmid? So if it has TI plasmid in it, it would induce tumor in plants. Okay. But why does it do? What is the need for a bacteria to induce the tumor in a plant? Because the reason is, when it induces the tumor in the plant, it gets a place and a lot of nutrition there to grow. So this is the ultimate, this is the aim of this bacteria, to grow at a large pace. So that's why it has this machinery. Now coming, so it is also called as nature's genetic engineer. Now we human beings, what we did is, like, we took this Agrobacterium tumefaciens. We saw this, okay, this is, it is doing. Now what can I do in this so that I can make something different? So before that, you need to see what is the mechanism in that. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens, it has this TI plasmid. This is how a TI plasmid looks. So what are the different components of TI plasmid? There is a tDNA, and you have opine catabolism genes, you have ORI, original replication gene, and you have virulence genes. So this tDNA, this is very important thing. This tDNA segment, this DNA, it is going to be transported inside the plant cell. It is going to fuse with the plant genome. Rest, this is not going to fuse with the plant genome. So only this thing is going to fuse. Now for transferring this tDNA, who is helping? These genes, virulence genes. They code proteins, virulence proteins, that helps to transfer this tDNA from this TI plasmid into the plant genome. Now this is, you can see opine. What is opine? Opine, these are the derivatives of plant's amino acids. So this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, it need nutrition. Okay, so what it does, it needs the nitrogenous nutrition. So what it does, it makes the enzymes of this opine. So opine would make an enzyme. That enzyme will going to make amino acid derivatives from the plant's amino acid. These derivatives can be used by this bacteria to grow. So this is the importance of this opine gene. Now this auxin and cytokinin, these are plant growth regulators. Why this TI plasmid has this? Because these are going to make this auxin and cytokinin, and they are going to proliferate the plant cells, which makes the plant cells what? Tumor. So tumor is being formed where it infects. So this is the story of TI plasmid. Now comes, which of the following statement are correct? It is asking which are of these are correct. Let's see first. tDNA contains only the genes responsible for the control of production of the plant hormones, auxin and cytokinin. What it says is, like, tDNA only has cytokinin and auxin, nothing else. Is it right? Wrong, because you can see opine here. Okay. So this is wrong. So first statement is wrong. Second, opines are carbohydrate derivatives. Is it? What did I just mention few moments back? Opines are amino acid derivatives. So they are not carbohydrate derivatives. This is also wrong. Both first and second are wrong. Different TI plasmid direct the synthesis of same opines. See, based on different types of opines TI plasmid makes, this different type of opine making TI plasmid, they are categorized into different types. So there are different type of opines, and according to them we name the different type of TI plasmid. So different So what it means is, like, in simple words, different TI plasmids makes different type of opines. Okay. Now coming to this statement again, different TI plasmid direct the synthesis of same opines. No, this is wrong, because the different TI plasmid direct the synthesis of different type of opines. This is also wrong. Fourth, opines provide a selective advantage to agrobacterium over competition from other microorganism. It means, like, other microorganisms, they also want to infect the plant, but they don't have the advantage. What advantage this has is, this agrobacterium has this opine thing, opine gene, so this makes opine this amino acid derivatives, so it uses it and grows, so it has the advantage over other microorganism. So this point is right. So only fourth is right, it is asking correct. So only fourth is correct, fourth is the only answer. So D is should be the answer. D is the answer. Okay. Okay, let's come to the second question. So embryo culture, as the name suggests, embryo is going to be formed. We are culturing the embryo, but what is the need of it? Why we do embryo culture? Suppose there is a seed which is not able to germinate. So you can say it is in dormant state, or it could be, you can call it as sterile. In that case, to solve this problem, what we do is we culture the embryo. Then from that plantlet can be made. So in this is the need of embryo culture. Now what is it is saying? Is that not the application of embryo culture? So production of virus free germplasm, no, this is not its application, because virus free germplasm can be made only when meristematic tissue is used. Meristematic tissue is found where? The apical part of shoot and root. This is not the application. Second, overcoming seed dormancy. Yes, when the seed is not it is in dormant state, and if you want to grow plant it from it, you can do embryo culture, which solves this problem. Third, so this is right, overcoming self sterility of seeds. If the seeds are sterile, yes, embryo culture can be used for that problem. 2 and 3 are right. Production of haploid plants, no, it is wrong. So 2 and 3 is, they are right. It is asking not the application. So first and fourth should be the answer, because these two are the applications. Okay, these two are not. 1 and 4 is not the application. 1 and 4 is, B is the answer. B is the answer. And this is a simple diagram regarding how embryo culture is done in the lab. You take the explant, you put the explant in nutrient media, then a callus is formed from that embryoid, and you can culture the embryo. Now coming to third question. So this question is asking about the plant growth regulators. What are their functions? So you need to learn some different functions of different kind of plant growth regulators. So there's a table you can see. This is the information you need to learn. So in the questions, they are asking of auxin, okay, and gibberellins and abscisic acid. But you should also learn for other also, like you have ethylene and abscisic acid, okay. So cytokinin, auxin, so you should also remember this ethylene also, and cytokinin is also. So just learn their function. So like gibberellin helps in germination. It is responsible for growth to maturity, for flowering, for fruit development, not in the abscission and not in seed dormancy. Likewise, you have another all kind of different kind of this plant growth regulator with their functions. So these three, they are very important. Learn about this. When auxin is present in high concentration, what would it do? It will promote root initiation. Learn this. Shoot growth will be induced by cytokinin, and gibberellin will stimulate cell elongation. So these three are very important. Learn this. Although you should learn all this, but these are more important. Now coming to question, high concentration of this, it is asking correct set of statements. So first, high concentration of auxin induces shoot formation. What auxin does? It promotes root initiation. So this is wrong. First is wrong. Second, low concentration of auxin induces root formation. it is not low concentration that induces, it is the high concentration that induces. So this is also wrong. If it were written that it high concentration is used, then it would be correct, but this it has written low concentration, so it is wrong. So these two are wrong. Third is the Gribble induces shoot elongation, right? You can see the elongation. Third is right. Abscisic acid causes maturation of somatic embryos. Yes, this is right. So 3 and 4 are right. It is asking correct set. 3 and 4 C is the answer. Okay. Now coming to the next, fourth question. So what is differentiation? What is de-differentiation? There is another term also which is called as re-differentiation. So what happens is like when a cell is, when it differentiates, it becomes a specialized cell. Okay, it both occurs in animals also and in plants also. But the difference is, plant has a very good, I mean, a very magical, you can say, and ability that a cell when specializes to another, like suppose this cell specializes to a, for example, leaf. A leaf cell or a root cell or shoot cell, whatever. Now you can make that cell to come back to the simple form, which is called as de-differentiated state. So this is called as de-differentiation. And again, you are inducing it to form this root cell. It is called as re-differentiation. This kind of thing happens only in plant. In animals, when a cell is differentiated to a specialized cell, it cannot revert back. Okay, it is a very, very major difference between plant cell and animal cell. So what is he saying? Differentiation of plant and animal cells is an irreversible process. Wrong statement. Irreversible process is for animal cell. It does not apply to and plant cell. So this is wrong. Second, plant and animal cells both follow same principle of differentiation and de-differentiation. This is also wrong, because just I said, animal cell can't de-differentiate, but plant cell can de-differentiate. So both are wrong. Both A and R are false. D should be the answer. It is written. Okay. Fifth question. This question is saying that a transgenic plant, it has the gene from where? Bacillus thuringiensis, and this is toxin. The gene is, it codes for insecticidal toxin. So what happens? This gene produces a protoxin. Protoxin means it has not come into fully functional state. It will not act as a toxin, it will not be toxic to cell. But when it is converted into toxin, it would be dangerous for the cell. It would kill the cell. Now, how does it happen? It happens because there are proteases in the intestinal gut of insect. These proteases, they cuts this protoxin, which makes the active toxin, and that kills the that insect. So the answer should be C, expressing endotoxin protoxin that is cleaved by proteases in insect gut and damages the surface epithelium of insect gut. Rest three are not the answers. They are saying that it polymerizes in insect gut, damages the immune system. No, wrong. It does not damages the circulatory system. It damages the surface epithelium of insect gut, and it is cleaved by proteases. So it's kind of information thing. You need to mug it up. It's not something to be calculated. Something. These plants, biodiversity, animal biodiversity, they are not of too much of concepts. Some small concepts are there, little concepts are there, and all you need to do is you have to learn many things in that. Sixth question. So what is asymmetric hybrid? Somatic hybridization, if you have heard, what does it mean? Somatic hybridization, what is somatic? Cell, a somatic cell is what? Which is not a germ cell. So if you take two different somatic cells and if you fuse them with together, the fusion cell will form a new hybrid cell, and it has formed from two somatic cells, you'll call it somatic hybridization. Just have a look on this slide. What you have done is they are showing two different kind of somatic hybridization. So this has two types. This is, one is symmetric fusion, another is asymmetric fusion. What does it mean? Suppose after this fusion of two cells, both the nucleus, both the genes of the parent cells, if they are inside, then what we will call symmetric hybrid. This is the hybrid formed from these two cells. Now it has the genes from both the parent cell. It is called a symmetric hybrid. Now suppose one, in this case it is asymmetric fusion. In this case, what you can see, among the two parental cell, this is parent one cell, this is parent two cell, one has degraded. So what is left? Only genes from a single cell. This is called as asymmetric hybrid. Okay. Now coming to this again, asymmetric hybrids are formed due to, so one thing you should note here, that among these two, what you can see here, this has lost the genes, it has lost the DNA. But if it occurs with this cell, not with this, then also you will say this is asymmetric hybrid. In simple words, what I can say to you is, if either of these two cells loses DNA, it will be called as asymmetric hybrid. So from both of the parents, from either of the parents, sorry, not from the both, from either of the parent cell, the DNA loses and it becomes asymmetric hybrid. Now coming to question again, asymmetric hybrids are formed due to losing of chromosome belonging from both the parents, is it right? No, from either of them, only from one parent cell. So this is wrong. Epigenetic change in one somatic hybrid while absence in other somatic hybrid, have we talked about epigenetic change? No, this is also wrong. Losing of chromosomes belonging to one of the parents, from one of the parents, two cells are there, parent cells, and the losing of DNA from either of them, this is right, C. So C should be the answer. Presence of full nucleus genomes from both the fusing somatic cell, no. It is asking about asymmetric hybrid. In asymmetric, both will not contribute to the total genomic DNA of the hybrid cell. We are coming to the next question, 7th. So somatic hybridization, as I just told you a few moments back, that it involves two somatic cells which hybridizes with each other and forms a new hybrid cell. So just have a look on this diagram. What you are taking is, you are taking two cells from two different strain A and strain B. So you are taking two cells, one from this, one from this, and you have fused both of them. So this fusion of two somatic cell, so these the cells, they are somatic, right? They are not germ cells, they are somatic cells. So these two somatic cells then fused, what they have formed is a hybrid cell. Now this hybrid cell, you can grow in this following stages, it forms callus and then it can differentiate to form the plantlet. So this is how a somatic hybridization is being done. And for this, there are some chemicals, there are like methods, you can use chemicals. Most common is polyethylene glycol. Polyethylene glycol is the most common used chemical for fusing these two somatic cells. Other than that, you can also give electrofusion technique. So there are techniques for doing this somatic hybridization. Now it is asking what is not correct about somatic hybridization. It combines cytoplasmic organelles from both the parents. Yes, because you are fusing two cells, so both cells will give will contribute the organelles present in it to a new cell. This is right. Protoplast fusion of two somatic cells can be induced by chemical electrical methods. Yes, chemical. I told you this chemicals they can be used. This electrical methods can be also be used. So this is also right. The most successful chemical fusion method is the addition of polyethylene glycol. Yes, this is the most successful. Last point, this is also right. So last point is chemical fusion method is generally less damaging than electrofusion for protoplast fusion of somatic cells. This is wrong, because chemical fusion is more damaging than electrofusion. So incorrect is it is asking. D should be the answer. D is the answer. Okay. 8th question. Somatic embryogenesis, what does it mean? Making of embryo from somatic cell. So if a single somatic cell, if you are going to make embryo from this, that kind of embryo is made from a zygotic cell or a non-zygotic cell? Think about it. A single somatic cell, a single somatic cell is not a zygotic cell. So somatic embryos, they are made from non-zygotic cells. So, and what you can do is this somatic embryos, you can put nutrition around them. You can put a layering, and that can act as artificial seeds. So these seeds, artificial seeds, can be used for growing the plantlet. Now it is asking which among this statement is not correct for somatic embryogenesis. It is the process of generation of non-zygotic embryos. Yes, this is right. Somatic embryos can be produced directly or indirectly. So this thing I would like to tell you, that this somatic embryogenesis are of two types, direct and indirect. What does it mean? From that somatic cell, if the plantlet is directly formed without the callus stages, that is called as direct. In indirect, that somatic cell divides and a callus stage is formed, then the complete plantlet is formed, that is called as indirect. So it is saying somatic embryos can be produced directly or indirectly. Yes, right, it is right. It cannot be used for production of artificial seeds. This is wrong. It can be used, as I just mentioned you, that you can cover it with nutrition and put a layering, you can use it as an artificial seed. So this statement is wrong. It can be used for mass multiplication of elite germ plasma. So it is made from a single somatic cell. If that has a good properties, you can use as a elite germ plasma. So this is wrong. It is asking accept. So it is asking which is not correct. C is the answer. So the thing is, how is this information changes? Why do the variations is produced in the plantlets? So if the mutation occurs and the sequence changes, there could be some variations in some of the plantlets. So this kind of variation in the clones is called as somaclonal variation. So this occurs in tissue culture. So which among the following is the source of somaclonal variation due to epigenetics? Now, what is epigenetic change? What is genetic change? What is epigenetic change? If the sequence changes, you can say it is genetic change. What is epigenetic change? Suppose the histone is being modified, okay, or DNA is being capped with a methyl group capping. So this kind of changes, they are called as epigenetic changes. So it is saying which among the following is a source of somaclonal variation due to epigenetic change. So for this you should look at it out that are they doing the genetic change or epigenetic change. Epigenetic change is just a local change in the DNA structure. It could be at like histone, or it could be as I just said about the capping of DNA. So basically in epigenetic change the sequence is not being changed. This is the important thing. So just see which are epigenetic in it. Changes in ploidy, yes, it is a genetic, it is not epigenetic. So this could not be the answer. Changes in chromosome number, again it is changing at the genetic level, it can't be the answer. Changes in cytoplasmic genome, again it is changing at the level of genome. So it cannot be the answer. Gene amplification, so a gene is simply amplified, the genetics is not going to change, the sequence is changing there. So D is the answer here. Okay, gene amplification. So it can make some variations in the different plantlets made from a single explant, and you will call it as somaclonal variation. Nice question. This is the last one. Which among the following is not a method for obtaining virus-free plants? So basically, virus. If you want to remove the virus, what you can do? You can treat it with the temperature. You can treat it with Maelzeil green or Uracil. Another thing is, if you take the meristematic cells, they divide at very fast pace. So virus is not going to infect the cells. Where are they found? At the tip of root and apical root, and at the apical tissue of shoot. So they have this meristematic tissue. So if apical part of the shoot and apical part of root, if they are taken and they are being used in the tissue culture, you will get what? Virus free plant. So it is asking not a method for obtaining virus free plant. Culture of apical meristem, it is a method for obtaining this virus free plant. High temperature treatment, yes. Treatment with Maelzeil green or Theraviocel, yes. Culture of leaf, no. You are culturing the leaf, you are not culturing the apical part of leaf, of that that shoot or root. So you are just using the leaf. So you are not using the meristematic tissue. So this is wrong. So this is not a method. So D is the answer. Okay guys, thanks a lot. In the next video, we'll have animal biotechnology. So stay tuned. Thanks a lot.